This is Jazz Man here again with another video of building electrostatic loudspeakers. Today I'm going to assemble one of the wire stators. And what we're looking at is my wire stretching jig and the jig that I build the stators in. I got a spool of wire over here. And okay, we're going to string the wire up now. This is something you want to wear gloves to do because it's very hard on the hands and fingers pulling this wire. You got to keep enough tension on the wire so that the wire stays on the pins. And there are 90 wires total in the array, so it takes a while to do this. And you got to keep tension on the wire until they get the wires all laced up on the jig. Kind of tedious task, but it has got to be done. Okay, the wires are all strung up on the jig now. As you can see, they're strung around the pins, and it's just hand tension on the wire, so the wires are got little kinks in them from the roll, and they're not all that straight, but they will be after I stretch them. I'm going to stretch these wire loops from 48 inches to 48 and a half inches. Probably hear my jig groaning a little bit now. That's a lot of force on these wires. So I stretch them about an eighth inch longer than the final length, and when I back off on the bolts, they're going to relax back about an eighth of an inch. So I got them stretched, relaxing them back out now. So now I'm going to take all the tension off, back to the relaxed state again. Now the wires are relaxed, but they're perfectly straight now. So now I'm just gonna put a little hand force on the bolts only. No wrench force, just hand force only. Tighten them down by hand. Now they're ready to build the stator. Okay, now I'm setting up the wooden lattice pieces in the jig. I've got wax paper down under the wires on the jig so that I don't bond my pieces to the jig. And you might have noticed my jig has a lot of slots in it. Well, this allows me to use little wooden wedges to secure the details into the jig. So I can just push this wedge in there, and now this piece is secured in the jig and it can't move. Now I'm going to install the wire spacers. I have some 3D printed pieces here that are going to space the wires apart. I used to use all thread rod, but I find it works a little better and easier after I've had these 3D printed wire spacers made up. So these have got little treads in them that are going to keep the wires separated real nice. And there again, I can insert these wire spacers anywhere I want along the length of the wires by putting the spacer in the slot, sliding it down. It self-centers between the stator wood details. And you'll notice, watch the wires. Wires are going to get straight as soon as I put a little pressure on here. Now this evenly spaces the wires out. And I'm going to arrange these along the length of the wire grid at several locations. Now you might notice I need to put a little downforce on these spacers to make the wires, to make these things function. And notice my jig has some horizontal slats here. So I'm gonna go over here and grab a bridge bar, slide in the jig over the spacer, okay? Then I'm gonna grab some of these little wooden wedges that I made up, slide them in place. And I can insert little wooden wedges across these bridge bars to put a little downforce on the wire. So kind of a nice feature of my new jig. Works very well. I'm real pleased with it. So I'll slide the wedge in and work it down. Now once I get a few more of these in place, the wires are going to straighten up real nice. Okay, I got the wire guides all in place now. Wedges in place, and you can see the wires are nice and evenly spaced all the way down. My 3D wire guides work really, really well. You know, back in the day, I used to use these to hold the wire spacing, all thread rod. In this case, 11 thread per inch. I think these are 5/8, 11 thread per inch, all thread rods. You can just drop these all thread rods in there, and they actually work really well. But, you know, you have to get them side to side and exactly centered and keep them all centered, and it's not nearly as easy as the 3D wire guides. So now it's time for me to start gluing the slats down that are going to secure the wires in place. And to do that, I'm using this E6000 glue, the kind with the fine tip on the end. And you don't need a huge amount of this glue, but you need to put an even bead across the contact surfaces. And the wax paper under the wires is going to keep the glue from binding the slats to the jig. This E6000 glue is sort of elastomeric. It doesn't get hard when it dries. It dries like a very hard rubber. And boy, it sticks to anything. And it's one of the few glues that will actually stick very well to the PVC insulation on the wires. So once get the glue on the wire, it's going to drop it in place. And like I say, these stator details are made to interlock and hold each other in location. And once I get it down, put a little wedge over here in my jig to wedge that in. Put a little wedge over here to wedge this end down. and my details in place. And I just got to do that for 17 more slats and we're done. All the horizontal slats are in place, glued down over the wires. Just got to let the glue sit and it's all good. Okay, the glue is set for about 8 hours and the lattice is down over the wires, all secure. This stator is just about finished. We're ready to take it out of the jig now. Out here on the end, once we get the stator out of the jig, we're going to glue on the end piece that's going to finally cover these wires here. It's going to go down like this, but we've got to get it out of the jig first before we glue that down. I'm just going to loosen the bolts up. Bump the plate forward. Okay, here's our completed stator. You can see this wax paper peel right off and there's our stator. Nice and clean, everything's flat, beautiful, beautiful.